putting bird feeders outside my kitchen window, and I'm planting a flower garden. We've been visiting nurseries and things lately and getting ideas for how we want to arrange it. It's amazing just what putting something bright outside your window can do to improve your whole day. It's also nice to put fountains in your homes, big or small. They have a calming effect on you. I think it's great to have something in life to feel passionate about. I found that the most peaceful, healthy people are the ones who are on their own time, like island time, or they have time in their life to devote to themselves, to have peace and harmony in their environment. Some people go to spas. I ran into someone yesterday when I was in line at Qdoba, and I couldn't believe how mellow that person was, really low key. And I looked on the back of their shirt, and they worked at a landscaping company. And if people look in the past, during the hippie days, do you see how people were so mellow? Then you got to realize there's something very evil taking shape in our environment today. That nowadays, all of that peace and harmony that let us feel close to God and heaven has been overshadowed by warriors in black, horror, suffering, terror. And you can see that a lot of people in charge have become drug addicts and abusers and gluttons, and their sinful lives and that of their offspring have made them very miserable, broken people. A lot of them are in counseling. A lot of them are so far out of their minds, they don't know reality from fiction. They're trying to make the whole world go Hollywood. It's gonna take a lot of suffering and shedding of nonsense that has surrounded us and sacked, you know, tarnished us and put a coating on us that has put up walls that we cannot lower without seeing what the problem is and who the enemy is. Through the enemy that is destroying our oppression of God, through the enemy that is trying to destroy biblical information, through the enemy that is trying to create different realities and fill our mind with such nonsense and craziness that we can't be happy, sane, and whole. Our children are being polluted with this stuff. Our children are being exposed to so much suffering and violence that they are traumatized before they even get out of high school. What sane adult can turn this around? What intelligent mind can turn this around? I'm just trying to show you the difference. When I went to Hawaii before when I was young, I was so transformed by the breeze. The island breeze was so special. It was like a soothing lullaby. And as soon as I got outside the airport, I smelled the plumerias, and it was such an intoxicating smell. It brought instant serenity. And then I stayed by the beach, and the calming effect of the ocean, just it had that sort of feeling too, that just went with the whole island. It was like a very spiritual place. And the longer I was there, the more I started realizing that other people had the same feeling. Everyone was on island time. They had something called aloha spirit. A lot of islanders were artists. I started collecting art I couldn't get here in Kentucky. When I went there, the colors here were dark greens, burgundies, browns. A lot of homes had dark colors. And I grew up in a home where a lot of my aunts had decorated, my older aunts. They're like in their 80s and 90s. And the wallpaper that long ago has come back now to be like the wallpaper you see in the home of aristocrats. And the antique furniture that I donated turned out later being priceless. Those things, to me as a child, were very grim. I liked bright colors. I liked modern things. I liked being able to use my creativity to fill my spirit soar, and that's why I chose writing and art whenever I was in college. And you can see how people that had that free spirited, happy go lucky nature and that open mind and spiritualism and natural outlook about life seem to have less worries, less stress, and they seem to be more in tune with their soul and with the spiritualism in others, because you have to be sensitive to pick up on those deep things. And our society today on the mainland is all about pushing people to excel for the dollar, work for the beast, and you're losing your inner magic and your connection to yourself. And now they have weapons now that detach us from ourselves, that even attack us. They attack me when I pray. They know my brain frequency. They can read, these people read my thoughts somehow. I don't know if it's alien or demon. I would guess demon. And they can try to devour everything that's good about me. It's like we've reached an age of destruction, and knowledge brought us here. When God said, don't eat from the tree of forbidden fruit, people did. And that sort of knowledge was destructive. But now you see people putting up at military bases, not just demonic things with codes and symbols, and putting numbers out there that have demonic meaning, and creating robots and technology that are demonic, that have been created through that. You see that these people are eating it up, but they're dying. The rage on their face, their broken lives, their fear, their controlism, it's overtaking. And you see them getting obsessed with blood and cannibalism and fire and fury, but you don't see them happy. Their faces do not display the spiritualism of Christ. Their faces do not show peace and light and harmony. They're going into the abyss. They're going to hell, and they want to lead us there. And unless people turn around and calm themselves down and detach, get closer to God, get more into the spiritual realm, start enjoying flowers and birds and nature, and getting away from so much evil and nonsense, and letting this fury and this force feed you, you're doomed. It's that simple. I put information out now through God, and people turn the opposite direction. People have been so programmed for so long, they only understand what they've been fed. And they're afraid to open up and accept a different way of thinking. And if they did, they would see their soul's richness, and they could turn to God, and they could turn to a positive force. They could let the peace on the earth fill them up. They could look for the beauty in the spirit rather than the evil. They would not be so enraged. They could let go of their fear, their insecurity. They wouldn't be trapped by this darkness, because darkness is an illusion. And you could have peace of mind if you could see that the light is always there. The sun is always shining on some part of the world as the world turns. You're never in total darkness. And God is always there.